So one other thing we spent almost no time on in the beginning and a lot of time on now is spam prevention. You think on a site like Reddit where it's like the Wild West, there's no rules, like anybody can submit anything, that'll just quickly be overrun with spam. You'd be surprised. Now that Reddit's big, yes, Reddit receives lots of spam. But at the time, if you understand spammers' motivations, it's really easy to prevent. A spammer's motivation is basically they want links. But an easy way to prevent their links from providing any value is to add an attribute to your anchor tag that looks like this. So if you have a link with this extra attribute, rel equals nofollow, basically tells Google this link shouldn't be followed for search quality purposes. Because the way Google works, right, is it looks at a given page, and however many pages elsewhere on the internet link to that page gives that page some authority. And you can basically say, I don't want to give this link any authority. And so every link on Reddit has rel equals nofollow until it has a certain number of points. Because we didn't want to put rel nofollow on all links because we liked the way the internet works. And we figured if a link was good on Reddit, that link should have some authority. Understanding that spammers are all they really want are links to increase the authority of their page to get more traffic there really helps. So this is one thing we did. Another thing we did was spam is rarely submitted by an individual by hand. There's almost always automated tools. Looking at the behaviors of these bots that were submitting contents to Reddit, they always had these kind of gaps, behavior gaps that humans would never do. For example, a bunch of users would all use the same password. Before we were hashing passwords, it was really easy for us to tell they were all using the same passwords. If there was 100 users all submitting crap, but they had the same password, it was all spam. And we could just remove it. And that worked out really nice. Eventually we started, hashing passwords and we lost that ability, but we had learned some other tricks along the way. One is that the users didn't understand the site. They would always submit a link and then comment on their own link. And legitimate users rarely commented on their own link as the first comment. And so we would just look for links that had one comment by the same author and mark it as spam. Spammers on a community site that behaves differently from other sites online, noticing that these people use the site in weird ways was enough to catch most spam. We didn't have to do any fancy like look for Viagra or look for suspicious looking links. A lot of these behavior heuristics worked really, really well. Submission rate. This is another heuristic. Legitimate users didn't submit that often. Or if they did, the time between submissions was stagnated, and spammers would often just submit a bunch of links at the same time. We'd look for those signs and ban the links. The most important thing that Reddit did, and still does, don't let them know when they're caught. When we'd ban a submission on Reddit, that user would still see their submission on our hot page or on their user page. If their vote doesn't count, it would still look like it would count. And if you try to figure out on Reddit whether your vote counts or not, it's really difficult to tell. Because on Reddit, there's a delay between when you click that button and when we update the score. I'm not going to get into the details, but suffice to say, it's really, really hard. And we've done this, we spent a lot of time making it so that users don't know when they're caught. And I've had to do this on AscuChan and on my blog as well, because a lot of you guys have submitted a bunch of crap to AscuChan and my blog that I didn't want to appear. A lot of that stuff is just sitting in Memcache and only you see it, but if you were to change computers, you would find that submission disappears. I think being subtle about when you've detected that somebody's spamming is really, really important. It's not the only solution, but security through obscurity works really, really well if you keep things obscure enough.